Welcome to the Swedish Defence University. In this webinar, we will be talking about the master's program in defence and security systems development. With me today, we have Klara Andersson, a student enrolled in this program, and Hans Liwång, head of subject for system science for defence and security and associate professor. Welcome.
Thank you.
The master's program in defense and security systems is quite unusual due to the variety of educational backgrounds for those who apply. What are some of the usual backgrounds for the students?
Well, I when you mention the typical backgrounds, you also limit the backgrounds. But generally, we have engineers coming from many different engineering fields, and we also have social scientists coming from, for instance, officers' education, but also other social scientist educations like political science, I think are good examples of students that we would like to go see at our program.
Clara, what is your background?
I'm a marine engineer with a master's in technical ship management. And I would say like the last 10 years, I've been working in the Swedish Merchant Navy as a third and second engineer.
Interesting.
Yes.
So this program is not only unique for its eligibility, but there are very few programs that are similar to this one in Europe. What is it that makes this master program so special?
Well, I really believe in the power of the diverse classroom and diverse program as well, and that's one of the backgrounds for developing this, that we would welcome and embrace this power and also these different types of students, like Clara here. We were not planning for having persons like Clara, but she were attracted by the program. And that, I think, both brings knowledge and perspectives to the program, but also to the classroom and the other students. So, for instance, shipping. Of course, that's an important aspect of our modern society that's involved in defense and security issues worldwide. But we were not really planning for these different, but we were aiming for embracing them. And of course, we needed to facilitate it as well. But we are still evolving in the different things that we are welcoming. So, yeah.
Happy to hear so. Mm-hmm. Clara, what made you interested in the first place when you applied for it?
I was actually thinking about another program. At first, I was interested in another course at this university. And then I had a friend who kind of nudged me in the right direction and suggested I should look up this program. And then when I researched it a bit more, I realized that I think this was more like better suited for my technical background, basically.
That's cool. Could you tell me a bit more in detail what you do in this program? How does it work?
Well, if we start with the start of the program, as we've talked about, these are different students coming from different backgrounds. So that means that the start of the program actually is different, but dependent on the background of the student. So we have the first half semester, we have one set of courses specifically designed for engineering people with engineering backgrounds, getting to know more about the defense and security sector. And people then coming from social scientist backgrounds with some knowledge about the defense and security sector, they take the understanding of engineering's role in development of systems of defense and security, which means that after during the first semester, they will get closer to each other, but still have different perspectives. And after that, then they all have a common theory course talking about the theories related to systems for defense and security. And after then, that the program is structured very much like many other master programs with a method course, but then also in-depth studies in different specific areas related to the topic.
Nice. Clara, what is the most fun and challenging part about this program from your own experience?
I think, at least for me, since I'm a civilian, I think the most challenging part is like understanding or maybe like learning more about the military perspective. But I think that also makes it more interesting because, I mean, it's a huge huge part of everything, basically, of daily life. And yeah.
So what happens when you finish this program? What is the future work prospects?
Well, there are several different working prospects. We worked a lot with the sector when we developed the program. And we saw that there is a need for people that works in between engineers developing the technical parts and other persons involved in organizational change and development tactics or development of procedures. And in between these two parts of the sector, there's a need for people making sure that we connect the technological development with the social development. And there are many different roles. For instance, you could work within the defense industry, making sure that the technology developed actually is suitable for the future. You could also work within an agency, for instance, related to crisis management, making sure that the systems that we have, for instance, in Sweden or another nation, are developed in order to really prepare us for as good as possible for the future crisis. Or there could be more specific military roles that you could fill. But in general, the sector of defense and security see a need for making better systematic choices in how to encounter the future needs and encounter the future threats or future crisis. And in that, we see many different roles for the students that have taken our program. And I also like to stress that given that the fact that our students have different backgrounds, they will all be very unique going out of the program because their background will be combined with this program and have very different, unique sets of experiences and skills, which means that there is not the same job for two different students on this program. They will aim for different types of roles within the sector. And that, I think, is really important also for the student to consider that they have a background experience that will have a big impact on what they take with them from this program as well.
So besides having the great opportunity to attend this program, why would you say that you should choose to study at the Swedish Defense University?
For me, I think it's similar to what Hans talked about. I enjoy like seeing the different backgrounds from the people in my class. And also I think it's, I liked what you call it, like the industry connection. Because of course it's important, I enjoy studying and gaining academic credits, but for me it has to be something else. It has to lead to like, or at least give me the feeling that this will lead to an opportunity to have a career within a specific field. So that's why.
Yes, and Clara mentioned the connection to industry as well as the sector, and we feel that we have a good the sector is really involved also in the performance of the program, the different courses, examples, and we also have the master degree project that you can do together with the industry or sector or agencies in Sweden or somewhere else, and that we have a closeness to the sector. That means that you will get a relatively large amount of contacts that you can use also after you have finished the program.
And just as this program, the Swedish Defense University of Role, has this connection to reality. Clara, but what do you think, what is your hopes for the future after this program?
My hope is that I will be able to combine, I guess, like the maritime or seafaring aspect of my career with hopefully connected to the defense industry. I'm hoping to perhaps gain a bit more of seagoing experience and then work at one of these companies within the defense industry that this program has like a good connection to. That is my goal, I think.
Interesting. Good, thank you.